So what was the holdup with the UFC? Like, what led you to not sign?
There was a lot of frustration over the years. I think since my fight against Stipe, my first fight against Stipe, my relation with the UFC never been the same.
Really?
Yeah.
Why? Never. In what way?
I don't know. I tried everything. I feel like I wasn't in the right place. And after that, then I get the Derek Lewis fight, who was like the worst fight. And that didn't help me at all. I think from that moment, I was already put in some position out there. Because I came back, I won multiple fights, and they came with a new deal. This was after Junior Dos Santos back in June 2017. And then until my team was on the way to the negotiation, who was in Anaheim when Stipe and DC was fighting the second time. And then I'm like, no, Dana said no new deal for Francis. He still have 3 fights on his contract. And to be honest, I was even happy because I wanted to knock that deal out. By that time, I understood a little bit about the market. I just wanted to fight out my contract and renegotiate as free. But a month after, we get a call from Hunter or somebody there. Yeah, they say, let's talk about a new deal for Francis. And at that time, like, there's not a new deal. We just want to fight, you know. It's already September, and my last fight was in June. I want to fight. So the new deal staff be holding me back. They didn't give me a fight.
Because they wanted you to sign a new deal.
They wanted me to fight.
You didn't want to sign a new deal. You wanted to fight your contract down.
I wanted to fight my contract down.
So they were slowing things down.
They were slowing things down. So that if you see, like, the interval between my Junior Dos Santos fight and Jairzinho Rosenstroke fight was almost a year. I mean,
it's also COVID, right?
In between, but without COVID, he would have still been like 10 months, right? And then from Junior, from Rosenstroke to Stipe, same thing. Then Stipe to Sirungan, almost the same thing. He was mostly about the contract.
So then finally, you fight out the contract, and then what happens?
We didn't come to an agreement at all, because during this time, there was still a negotiation pushing and stuff, and I wanted to fight out that contract. Proposal of money, obviously they know my position because I was pressured financially. You know, when you have a fight, you expect to fight at least at that level. At that moment, I was expecting to fight at least 2 or 3 times a year, right? Then I get to the point that I have one fight, I have nothing. So I was limited of income, stuff like that. Then I started borrow money. Even before the Stipe fight, when they announced that fight, I need to call to ask for advance of my purse to finance my training camp. I have no money, but I was there training and getting ready for almost a year. So I took some advance. So
that's got to be very stressful.
Yeah, but one thing, and that's like one thing that I'm always grateful about my life. I used to this situation, and I told myself, like, these people, they don't know me. I can live out of nothing. You know, I live in
the
street, bro. Yeah. Like, and then I'm here in Las Vegas. You think like, okay, I don't fight. I just have to change everything. I'm able to live out of the bare minimum. And I don't care if I walk around, you guys say, oh, champ, oh, that's a UFC contender, whatever it is. Man, I just live based off what is in my base of my asset. I don't live beyond that. That's why, like, I don't really trust those credit card system or those loan and stuff. That's America shit, bro. I don't trust that, because when he lets you down, he lets you down.
Yeah, for sure.
I check my wallet. Whatever is in my wallet, I live based on that. I don't go loan and stuff unless, like, I'm forced at some point, or it's an investment, like having taking the money, borrowing money for your training camp, you know,
right.
That's a different thing.
UFC yearly holds 15 PPV cards, each priced at $79. Now, if you've ever thought about buying all 15 of these cards in a year, it adds up to a staggering $1,185, and that's not even counting big boxing matches. But guess what? There's a solution called iWatchMax, and it's a total game changer. Imagine this. For the price of just 2 UFC fights, you can watch all the UFC and boxing matches for an entire year, saving over $1,450. But here's the kicker. It's not just about UFC and boxing. With iWatchMax, you can also catch all sorts of sports from MLB to NFL, NBA, soccer, and even the latest movies and TV shows. Here's how it works. iWatchMax is a super exclusive streaming service. They don't let everyone in. Only a select few make the cut. To see if you qualify, all you need to do is take a quick quiz on their website. Once you're in, It's as easy as setting up an app on your device, adding your info, and you're good to go. And here's the cherry on top. You'll get free access to the latest movies and TV shows when you make your purchase. For more details, head over to iWatchMax.com/qualify.
So you win the Ciryl Gane fight. Then what happened?
Well, then first Dana didn't come to the ring, to the octagon for the belt. Yeah, and then after that, they get this dinner, invite us to this dinner, trying to smooth things out. Again, the condition at that time, I think at that time for me, he was more than a contract. He was like a lot of frustration from the past almost 3 years, you know. I'm like, okay, I have no guarantee that signing this contract, I will not get into what I have been to in the past 3 years. So how about we change something that will make me feel secure?
And what did you want to change?
A lot of things. I want in my contract, first of all, I want a contract without extension, because I have seen how they can abuse of those extensions.
Can you explain to me how the extension works?
Oh, well, I mean, there's not a way that it works. The extension is that, because they say if you deny a fight, they can extend you for 6 months or something. If you're hurt and can't fight, they can extend you for 6 months or something. But the problem, the UFC is the judge and the party. They decide if we extend you. You have no say. So when they say, oh, you fight tomorrow, you say, no, I'm like, okay. No problem, we were just checking. And then maybe a week after, you will receive a letter of extension, like your contract has been extended once. And that's what happened with me.
If you're injured, like say if they propose a fight for you, like here we are in September. Mm-hmm. If they propose a fight for you in Madison Square Garden in November, and you say, I can't because I'm injured.
Oh, no, that extension.
Then they put up a six-month extension in the contract.
Oh, yeah, that's extension. That's
anytime you refuse a fight, is that what it is?
Yeah, and refuse is subjective.
Right.
Depend of the
it
term
could
of
mean
subsistence.
You can't fight because you're injured, like when you tore your knee ligaments.
Oh,
like,
no, that is an extension.
Extension.
Yeah, yeah, that's clearly an extension. For example, my extension, for example, the first one, when I fought Stipe, right? And I have been fighting almost once a year in the past 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
I fought Stipe on March 27, and then April 2nd, Mick is calling my team. And I tell them, like, oh, I want to fight, stay active. I want to fight twice this year again. Summer, which is July or August, and December. And then April, they are calling to ask me to fight. And I was getting ready. It was a big moment in my life. I'm like, I'm bringing this trophy home. This trophy
right.
home. Right. And this call to ask me if I can fight in June 12th. I'm like, bro, give me a time. I mean, if they say no, we were just offering in case, because Francis said he want to fight twice this year. I'm like, yes, I do. And I said July, the earliest, and August and December. And I know that I can take 2-3 weeks out, maybe go home, do stuff and come back. And they say, no, it's okay. No problem. We were just checking. A couple months after, I received an extension about that.